Burns. What is the definition of burn? Burn is actually injury or coagulative necrosis of the skin and other tissues by physical or chemical agent. What is the etiology of burn? The etiology of burn is physical agents or chemical agents. The physical agents may be usually thermal injury by flame or hot water and steam. And injury and burn by hot water or steam is called scalds. Electrocution is burn due to electricity, electric shock. Also, irradiation produces burn, or friction burn. Friction burn, typical example in motorcycle accidents, in which there is friction of the skin against a hard object, leading to injury of the skin. And this friction burn is actually abrasion with heat burn. Cold injury due to injury of the skin by freezing. Chemical agent may be alkalis or acids. What is the classification of burn? Pathology and classification of burn. First of all, we classify burn according to the depth of injury. We all know that skin is formed of epidermis and dermis. And under the dermis, under the skin, there is subcutaneous fat or called the hypodermis. And deeper to this fat is deep fascia, muscles, and bones. The first degree of burn is just damage of the epidermis only. And typical example is sunburns. This burn, which is first degree affecting the epidermis only, produce erythema of the skin and heal spontaneously and rapidly within few days. Second degree of burn is affection of the epidermis as before, plus part of the dermis. If the epidermis and the superficial part of the dermis is affected, this is called superficial partial thickness burn. And usually this heal within 2 weeks. There is deep partial thickness burn, which is affection of the epidermis and superficial and deep part of the dermis. And this take a longer time for healing. It heal within 3 to 4 weeks. Third degree of burn is complete destruction of the skin, destruction of whole epidermis and the dermis. And this is called third degree burn or full thickness burn. Fourth degree of burn is affection of the deeper tissue, affection of muscles, tendons, and bones. Clinically, how to differentiate between second degree of burn and third degree of burn, which is partial thickness burn and full thickness burn. This is the superficial burn affecting the epidermis only. Affection of the superficial part of the dermis is second degree, called superficial partial thickness burn. affection of the deep part of the dermis is called deep partial thickness burn. And the third degree is full thickness burn affecting the whole epidermis and the dermis and involving the subcutaneous tissue. Clinically, this is the difference between the three types of burns. Just erythema, first degree of burn. Formation of pulley and the blisters. This is the second degree of burn. Formation of dead tissue called the eschar is the third degree of burn. How to differentiate between second and third degree, which is partial thickness and full thickness burn? First of all, pain. In partial thickness burn, there is remaining part of the dermis healthy, and the remaining part of the dermis which is healthy containing the cutaneous nerve endings, which is very sensitive, leading to pain. And this can be detected by hair pulling test, or pain break. If the patient feel any pain during hair pulling or pain break, it is a partial thickness burn. While in full thickness burn, the whole dermis is destroyed, which containing the nerve endings, and the nerve endings of the skin are completely destroyed, leading to full thickness burn is painless. What is the appearance of the burn? Presence of blisters. This is the blisters. And redness. Shiny skin with intact capillary circulation. You press the burned area and remove your finger. Blanching of the burned area will recover and become red again. This is called capillary refilling, and this is called normal capillary circulation. In contrast to full thickness burn, in full thickness burn, the tissues are dry, dead white, or brown, or black, according to the time of contact with the fire or the heat source. This lead to formation of a slabs called the eschar. The eschars show loss of luster and no capillary circulation, dead tissue. If you press, no color change. If you remove pressure, no color change. This means complete dead tissue, eschar, and no capillary circulation. There is marked difference in healing. Healing of partial thickness burn. If there is no infection, epithelialization. From the remnant, hair follicle, sweat gland, and sebaceous gland. This is partial thickness. There is remnants of hair follicle and sweat glands in the dermis, and the proliferation of cells from the depths will leading to epithelialization of the surface and complete recovery. But if infection occurs, infection will destroy the remnants of hair follicle and sweat glands, leading to change of partial thickness burn in case of infection to full thickness burn and healing in a longer time. In case of full thickness burn, The iskar separates after about 4 weeks, leading to exposure of granulation tissue. And there is no epithelial remnants in the burned area. The dermis is destroyed with complete destruction of the hair follicle and the sweat glands. Therefore, healing from the edge of the burn by very slow epithelialization. And if no grafting, leading to healing by extensive scar in a very long time. We can classify burn according to the extent of the burn. Extent of the burn into minor burn, intermediate burn, and major burn. Minor burn is burn less than 10% in children, or 15% in adults of total body surface area. Intermediate burn is burn between 10 to 30% of surface area of the body in children, and 15 to 30 in adults. Major burn is burn more than 30% of the total body surface area. How to estimate the surface area burned? We can estimate the surface area by this simple rule, which is called the rule of 9. In adults only. The rule of 9 mentions that the head and the neck, each upper limb, is about 9% of the body surface area. Head and neck and each upper limb is 9%. And lower limb, front of lower limb is 9%. Back of lower limb is 9%. Therefore, each lower limb is 18%. Also, front of the trunk is 9%. Back of the trunk is 9%. Therefore, the trunk as a whole is 18%. If you sum all the percentage mentioned, it is 99%. Where is the remaining 1%? This is the remaining 1%, which is the perineum, is 1%. The rule of 9 is not applied to infants and children. And always remember that the head and the neck in infants and children about 18% of total body surface area. And the limbs are very small in relation to the remaining surface area of the body. We mentioned pathophysiology of burn in the next video. Thank you for good listening.